you probably have a total of 5 minutes to decide if now is your time. And why wouldn't it be? Unless you're at work. Okay. It's happening. Like I said, if you're just joining us, we are working today on balancing and turns. So we're gonna do a couple turn combinations in the center, and then a bunch of prep work at the bar. I'm gonna try and squeeze in as much as I can to get us prepped for our balancing and the octave turning, which is harder than it looks. Okay. We love this song. Here we go. I think it's our time. I think it's our time.
Oh.
Don't beat yourself up. If you get frustrated at any point, I want you to think of your inner teacher. What would your inner teacher tell you? And make it kind. Okay? So we are nothing but kind to ourselves. If something is not feeling right, typically that means that we're either too rotated and like we're not holding it. So narrow your rotation so we're not here, but we're here. And that calls for when the legs are lifted as well. We're not here, but we're here. And or maybe our legs are going a little too high and there's like a pain or a strain or something, so lower the legs, okay? If you're on a balance and you're getting really frustrated, lower the heels, take a second, realign yourself. Anytime you are feeling frustrated, take a moment for yourself, whether you're losing the combination or not, it does not matter. You'll pick up with me whenever you get your moment, but get your bearings, because you can do this in this kind of class. We're live on TikTok, but I cannot see you. Whereas in a ballet class, it's harder to take a moment while everybody's keeping going. You know what I mean? So now is your chance to treat this like not one of those other ballet classes that you've taken before, and or if you've never taken ballet, it's a time for yourself. Yeah, so start looking inward and connect inward. Yeah? All right, the feet are in parallel, directly under the hip points, and or wherever you can make it a little wider, but not narrow. Okay, we're gonna take the right arm, bend the legs, and scoop the arm up like an ice cream scooper, up and over. Just take a light side bend to start. Don't shift the hips over and flop. Hold the core a little bit, take a deep breath in, and then exhale, come back. We're gonna do this with music. I'm just going over it. Scoop the left arm, I have a chair here. Up and over, light side bend, connect to the core, deep breath in, fill the stomach, and exhale, return. We're gonna do that again. And you can take this one a little bit further this time if you have the range, yeah? And then left one more time and up. Then we're gonna take shoulder and head circles. So instead of like cracking your neck around in a circle, I want you to think really long, like you're painting a circle above your head with the top of your head. Does that even make sense? We're gonna do four. So my neck is staying super long, my shoulders are staying away from my head. And then you're gonna do four the other way. You can have a soft bend in the legs, or swaying from one foot to the other. Should feel fun and good. We're gonna center, and then we're gonna do a big yawn stretch. Both arms, and then shimmy it down, shake. Big yawn stretch, shimmy it down, shake. Two more, big yawn stretch, shimmy it down, shake. Then we're gonna transfer the weight to the left leg. Instead of thinking about transferring the weight into the left leg, transfer by lifting up first and then going over. We're gonna just play with pulling the knee up and down slightly. Was anybody else in Adrian's class just a second ago? And then we're gonna catch the knee. If you're feeling already like, oh my God, hold on to your bar and give it a little bit of attention, but try not to like vibe here, but feel pulled up on this side. You're gonna hold, this is where we're starting our balance practice. So we are pulling up on the kneecap, pulling up on the hip flexor, wrapping around with our glute and down with the tailbone. So instead of boop, we're like this. Okay? If your knee is not that high, it's totally fine. If you can barely do that, under the thigh here, also works. Cool? Find what feels right for you. Don't copy my shape, find what feels good on you. Okay, we're holding that, it's going great. We're gonna switch to the other side. So if you need the chair, you'll have to turn around or place your chair just sideways so that you can still see me. Otherwise, we are transferring the weight, lifting the hips up and over first, playing with this a couple times. Find all four corners in the feet, so touch these bones right here. Touch the big toe bone, touch the pinky toe bone, and then push them down equally. And then feel your heel also push down equally. And then the edge of your foot really pressed into the ground. The only thing that's not on the ground is the arch of your foot. Okay, unless you have extremely flat feet, in which case it will be on the ground and that's fine. Then you're gonna grab it, clasp it, squeeze it, holding, pulling the kneecap up, grounding down with the tailbone, down with the shoulders, down with the rib cage, up with the back of the head. We're holding that for a bit. This is your initial balance practice. So if you're falling, that's okay. That's you being human, that's you warming up. I just took yoga with Adrian, so I'm feeling a little bit grounded and like, yes. So that's why I'm like, here I am. But take time, be patient, okay? And we'll just finish after that. It's okay, I'm gonna do it with you. So if you forgot literally everything, you're gonna be fine.
See a girl's too good to be true. Paper white teeth.
Here we go. Perfect body. Feet are hip distance underneath. Parallel.
It's not my lack. But it feels
stacking.
Like that weight is on my back. And I can't let
deep
it go.
Grab lower on the leg underneath the thigh. Otherwise, we're squeezing the knee up to the chest. Tailbone long behind you. Feel the back of the knee really straight. Deep breath in. Exhale, slowly release it down. Shake the other leg up. Ready, transferring up and over, right leg. Start playing, up and down. I'm gonna give her shit for this song, but this is a good fucking song. We're clasping the knees. You may grab your bar. Up on the hip flexors, down with the tailbone, down with the shoulder blades. Here we go, deep breath in. Exhale, release it down. Shake it in and out. Nice. Bend. Okay, I want you to wipe whatever happened in your balance. Don't be saying, oh my God, my balance was so off, now my pirouettes are gonna be trash. Who are you helping by convincing yourself that you're gonna fail already? Yes, that was the first thing of the day. We're just figuring out our balance. Yes, so we are going to steadily progress that balance, I believe in you. With pliés, we're in first. First position is feet together. You rotate, wrap. First position is not feet together, I'm sorry, I didn't finish. You're rotating, wrapping your legs, feeling like they're opening and then pulling together at the back of the inner thighs, and then pop your feet open. Wherever they popped without you sticking out your glutes and then opening it, try and think of wrapping the glutes, squeezing the inner thighs together, and then pop them open. All right, we're gonna keep the hand on the hip today. Plie. And stretch. Plie. And stretch. Your plie will look different from my plie. Maybe you only have this much. Okay? Don't go any lower to where you're losing your glutes back there. Try and think about squeezing the glutes, maintaining its stretch. Squeezing, wrapping around the glutes, and stretch. Then you're going to rise up. Hold. If you want to let go for a second, you can. Otherwise, just keep it on the bar low. We're gonna grand plie. If grand plie is not for you, do two more demis. Just like we did at the beginning. Grand plie, down, two. You're gonna let go here, three. I'm torturing us, four, but this is so good for your balance. Come up, six. Try and do it without the bar. If you need the bar there, by all means, please keep hold of it. And then we're gonna tendu second. Adjust the inside foot so you're a little wider. Yeah, don't just lower a second and then like, take a wide stance. Demi, stretch. Demi, stretch. We're rising straight up. Back of the knees lift into the pelvis. Really connected here. Let go if you can. If you can't, maybe do a lower. We're grand plieing. Two. We're letting go here. Three. Four. We're pushing the ground away. Six. Adjust. Boop. To fifth. We're skipping fourth. Fifth is big toe touching the heel. Big toe touching the heel. You're in the same rotation that you had in first, but in fifth. Cool? Demi. Stretch. Keeping the heels pressed into the ground. Stretch. Rise up. Hold it. Just find your alignment. Maybe you're not letting go, but you're thinking about connecting your core. Lower the heels. Grand plie. The trick to this, which I will explain, is not getting all the way down here, letting go, and then trying to come up from here, because now you've dumped all your weight onto your legs, and trying to access the strength into your legs again is going to be like ripping muscles. Don't do it. So what you're going to do is feel this lift in your pelvis into your core the whole time. Grand plie, I'm thinking my pelvis staying lifted too. It's still lifted 3, 4. It's still lifted 5, 6. And then we're gonna go open arm out to second. Lift a little bit to fold forward.
2. I'm folding forward to wherever I can fold forward without losing my glutes. So try not to completely fall back in the thighs like this, but keep wrapped and forward over the toes. Yes, hold 3, 4, and then roll the spine up 6, 7,
arm is going up 8. We're bending back, opening the chest, and then coming up. That's another one where you don't wanna lift up to go back, and it might just be a little is a lot. And then we're done.
This is really hard, but we're really trying to get some strength in these legs to prepare us for balancing and turning on them. That's the goal.
Cool. Here we go. First position, 2 demis, arise. A grand plie, you let go, you come up without grabbing the bar, if that's your prerogative. If you need to keep hold of the bar, more power to you.
Do we have questions?
Oh, yes, it is hard, Pink House, but Whiskey Grandpa, I'm really glad to hear it. I mean, I'm not glad to hear that you've never been explained this stuff before, but I'm glad that you're connecting to a different idea of it now. It is really hard. That's really good to acknowledge. So good to just say, oh, this is hard.
I'm caught up in my dream.
Oh, I'm doing something really hard right now.
Just
and I'm gonna keep
air.
Going. You know?
So good, I'm
got it. The most important part on this grand plié coming up. Weave this together. Able to access your muscles, do it in first. Do it in first one more time. It's a lot easier because you're feeling really like everything is stacked, whereas in fifth, it's like difficult to figure out, am I on my front leg, my back leg, am I centered in it? Yeah, I'm from a professional. Yeah, well, it's been a pandemic, but we're working on it. Okay, here we go. Left side. Say, I believe in me. I believe in me. Here we go. First position. Deep breath in. Exhale, release it. First position. Hands on hips. Ready? Seven. My dad took me out of ballet classes because he thought dance was inappropriate. What? Then after class, my legs felt like they were wrapped in bubble wrap. Oh my gosh, wait, I missed like the first part of that, I think. Left side was way harder, especially that fifth position grand plié. That is also something great to acknowledge. Just go like, oh yeah. That's different. That side was just different. Okay, we are going to, we're not following a typical structure today as far as a ballet class because I really want to work on balance and turns, yeah? So we're gonna start a little bit away from the bar. I'm just starting on whatever side I just finished on because I don't want to move my chair back and forth unnecessarily. We're gonna start in first. You're gonna tendu. Close first, tendu, close first. Then you're gonna tendu, plie on your standing leg without dipping in the hip or taking one hip up, but really level it, keeping the knee over the toe wrapped, feeling under the glute. And then you're gonna step, just flat, close first. Then go away from the bar, tendu, close first. Tendu, close first, third one, tendu, plie on that standing leg, level hips, step flat, close. So I'm stepping onto a straight leg, even though I'm coming from this plie leg. I'm thinking of going a little past my toe and then stepping over. How are we doing? Are we okay? So this, we're working on shifting the weight and being able to go from all of your weight on one leg to really starting from the hips and the rib cage. Everybody do this. Wrap one hand around your rib cage, one hand on your hip, plie, and then use a little force, push that over onto your standing leg. You should be able to lift this other leg now. It should be free. If you've got a little bit of weight on it, you'll fall. Yeah? So this is really setting you up for turns. Try the other way. Tendu, wrap one hand here, grab the hip, plie, use a little force, push with your hands, and then try and lift that leg off. Are you free? Okay, now try it just imagining that your hands are there. Your hands are on your hips, so I guess you kind of have a cheek here, plie, push, think of it. Lift that leg, are you balanced? Try this side, plie, push. Lift that leg, are you balanced? I am wrapping my glutes around the whole time. Ballet booties are interesting because they're more inwardly strong than outwardly strong because of how much we're wrapping in and up. Okay, how are we? Honestly, still kind of scarred when you taught ballet at Source. I was not as kind back then, let me just say that. Not that I was like a terror, but I was definitely more of a ballet teacher that was like, get your leg up. And now I'm like the complete opposite of that almost. Okay, here we go. This is it. We're doing that like twice and then we'll go to the other leg. Try not to let anything happen in this forward to back plane. So I'm showing you my front view, but my side view, theoretically, would stay in between two walls. I'm stepping to the side, but I'm not like giving my plie a little oomph and then like using this force to get me onto my leg. Does that make sense? Starting away from the chair. 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 2, We're gonna go to the other side. I hope that's going well for everyone.
Picking up the chair and or whatever you're using. And here we go. We're about to amp this up. So you know what's coming. 7. I'd rather you fall over it too far than not quite make it. Follow your fears. Go. Your foot will catch you. My foot will catch me. Go.
Okay, good. Killing it, queen. Queen. I'm a
obsessed with Queen. Paul Taylor is shaking. Shut up. Thank you so much, Bug Bite. 69. Okay, we're gonna amp that exact same combination up. And we're taking it to releve. Now, if you were struggling getting onto your leg in the last combination, do that one again. You can do that one without the bar, maybe. Eliminate that safety net. You can just move it off to the side. Or you can try this a more advanced version. But set the proper expectations for yourself about this. You know what I mean? We're still gonna be in first. Whew. Tom, do one. Close, similar. Two, close. Three, plie. You're gonna step up to releve first. Then you're gonna let go. Two, three, four. So we're holding this time. Lowering the heels straight down. Six, seven, eight. So even though we're lowering the heels, we're feeling this pull up through the center channel to go left. Two. This one's harder. There's no safety net. Three, plie, releve, pique. So onto a straight leg. That's the hardest part. Holding. Two, three, four. Lowering. Six, seven, eight. So I'm going to show you the hardest part right now. And you can do it wrong if you would like right now. Try that. Pique, plie, tendu, pique on it with a bent leg, and then come up to your other leg. Do you see how it looks and feels? Try the other leg. Yeah, I'm exaggerating it. Most often, what happens is this. A relaxing of the leg. So I want you to really try. And if that just means that you can't go as far away from the chair, that's totally fine too. Manage your expectations. I want you to try and keep the top of the leg and the back of the leg really pulled up as you peek in. So you're coming onto that leg. Sick. Straight leg. So hard without arms, literally. But like, really gonna set you up for success. If you can do it in this like thin, but like plain, where you're a piece of paper vibe, rather than like this helpful energy that you have, you're gonna be set up for extreme greatness. You really have to zoom out there and trust the leg, exactly. It is so much harder than it looks. Acknowledge it. But thank you. Okay, here we go. Same song. The only thing that's different is that we're holding for a four and lowering for a four. And we're on releve.
Now we're going.
Remember that. Hold, connect here. Hold, connect here. Wide with the elbows. So even though our hands are on our hips, don't make it like this, or you'll fall backward because of where that's putting your hip. It's already behind your hip.
Yeah.
that's my wrist cage, so I'm reminding you, once you get there, hold this wrist cage up, ready? Maybe put your hand here right now. So you're thinking of pulling it up. I just believe. I really do. Okay. Yeah. I don't want this to get like boring, but we're just amping up the same combination again and adding an optional turn to it. So this time we're gonna be in fifth. So once again, if you're really struggling and that was very challenging for you, continue to do that version. If you're feeling like, oh, I wanna try something maybe a little harder, we're gonna do this one. So now we're starting in fifth, which we did at the bar with those pliés, but now we're gonna tendu, changing legs. So you're tenduing side, but you're closing back. Same leg is tenduing side, closing front. Third set, tendu side, plié. Now you're gonna cross pique susu. I'm gonna show it first. Pique susu. So you're crossing the other leg instead to first, but up and into fifth on releve. Really tight and squeezed. Cool? Then we're gonna do the same thing, letting go. Now, if you would like, you may take an arm to en avant for balance here. Two, three, four. We're gonna separate the legs just a small amount, soutenu sharp around to the other side, and then sharp back, and then lower. Okay, I'm gonna show that like three more times. So if you need to come up to the screen, really inspect what's happening. I'm balancing for four counts, and that's okay if you're not able to let go. You can still try the turn, because you have the bar right here. It's right here, I know you can't see it. You're gonna open the arm out, separate the legs just a touch to get you to the other side, squeeze the legs back in on the other side, separate, squeeze them back in, lower, fit. So what I'm doing is really whipping the head and arm together and then opening my arm out straight away, closing it together with my head and my arm, opening it out straight away. Okay, susu. Susu, you really need to feel like your feet are pressing together. Your calves are pressing together. Your knees are pressing together. There has to be energy. Because I say to all my clients, you can do a susu with no energy squeezing in towards your midline. And then this stuff happens. This stuff happens, we're not able to find it. If you access from the bottom up, squeezing your ankles together, squeezing your calves together, knees together, inner thighs together, pelvis together, core together, you are setting yourself up for success. Your glutes are together, I promise. And that is the access that you turn on. You can do a dead turn, not engaged in any way, but your axis is not strong. Okay, so that's what we're working toward, a strong axis. All right, let's just do one. Let's just do the one that goes into the bar. If you're doing the last combination that we just did, it's the same music, so I hope we're not bored, but I think we're having right. Then you might go right and left. You have enough time. Okay, here we go. I think. What's my? Y'all see? Here it is. It's like, do y'all see it? Okay, here we go. We're starting away from the bar.
No, we're going.
My right foot is in front. I'm going to my right. fifth, changing legs. When you finish Sinsu, your left leg will finish. You're turning toward your bar both times. Say, I believe in you.
Ballet, or try, just do your best. to get into retire positions. Okay, so a retire.
Actually, let's start with a coup de pied. You start in fifth. A coup de pied pulls up to just the top of the ankle bone. Yeah, so not too low down here, a little higher. Some practices are low, I guess, but I teach it a little higher. You're grounding down with the standing leg. Same deal. Pulled up. Everything's always pulled up. And then you lift it up the leg to go to retire. Now yours might only lift to here. It takes a long time to get the strength in the hip flexor to be able to lift it much higher. So acknowledge where you're at today and be patient with yourself, okay? Please. It's the least you could do for yourself. We are wrapping the glutes around. This is so similar to the what we were doing at the beginning of class, which is why we did it at the beginning of class, to bring it in here. So we're going coup de pied. Think, this helped one of my clients, think that you're like, there's a wall here, and you're pressing into it to shift to your back leg. You're pressing into an active leg force. Because if you feel like there's nothing there, then there's nothing there. You know what I mean? So ballet is all about having collective forces on all sides of you to hold you where you are. But it's really about the imagination. And like you really need to feel like there is something there holding you. Yeah, so pick up the front foot with that control in the back. Bring it up to a retire. I'm sorry, we're hand on the chair. We're taking it down to coup de pied, back up to retire, lifting it a little bit to close back. Coup de pied. I'm using my quarter bra, but if that's really stressing you out, keep the hand on the hip. Coup de pied, low in the back. Just my heel is touching to the back, so no longer my toe. If you don't quite get this today, that's okay. It's behind you, so it's really hard for our brains to be like, forward, back. Well, it is difficult. So pick up the foot. Whatever happens, happens. Slide it up to the back of the knee, pointed foot. Back to coup de pied. Back to retire. Pass it. Close. Fifth front. Cool. Then we're going to quarter bra forward in fifth.
Two. Then we're going to take it into the bar. So what you're going to think about is your right pectoral muscle opening
as your booty comes underneath you. Okay? So one more time,
as your booty comes underneath you, your right pectoral muscle opens.
Yes, and then come up, and then finish really strong. Now, option to lift the front foot for a moment without the bar, and then just put it down. See how we're doing there, yeah?
Get into it yet.
Okay, we're changing the song, finally. Coup de pied, retire, coup de pied, retire, passe, close. Coup de pied. Actually, it starts slow. Retire. Then these are quicker. Coup de pied, retire,
you need to beat it, it can text it, freaky. I don't wanna beat it, and just to let you go, this can happen.
So that we feel like strong. Yeah, chill and coupe, coup de pied, whatever you call it. that coup de pied position is the low position. So if you wanna just come up to that position and try and find your balance there, more than welcome to. Thank you for that reminder. Genovia Embassy from Princess Diaries. My tendu feels like it's drifting outward. Oh my God. Thank you for saying that. Thank you for asking a question, but not really asking a question. So you see how your legs are really crossed here? If you think about where your inner thigh is here, your inner thigh to the back is actually going this way to connect to your calf, right? So you want to think about maintaining that thigh shape even as it goes back and then closes in. Otherwise you're going out and in like a little fish tank. And it's not that it's ugly, but it's just
unfortunately not right. And it's a lot easier to stay on your standing leg if you're thinking about crossing that inner thigh from the top of the pelvis. Maybe that helped, maybe it did not. Maybe I could explain it in a different way. Do it with your hands. Try the other leg. Try it with your hands. Punch down and across like this. And take whatever leg was in back to the back of your other hand. Try it a couple times. One more. Okay, now I want you to tendu and do the same thing with your legs. Maybe more somatic ideas helps. Okay, cool. It looks like we got it. I love that. Excuse me. All right, pick whatever leg you want to get out of the way with first. And just start there. Okay. I'm trying to take my own advice here. Right on that standing leg. Scoop it up, right to your right. Or let go, maybe. Really control, taking it down, cross it, same feeling. Straight back leg, rotate your front leg, pull up to fondue. Close it. How did we do? We're going to the other leg. Here we go, other leg front. We'll talk about it right after this. 7, 8, cross there. I was swimming in the Caribbean. 2. Good. I'm also hiding behind the energy on that front leg, just take it straight up. Except the little fish. Finding it, letting go. Now, just for funsies, we're gonna come center. This is the last thing we're gonna do. And we are going to do that combination, but any amount of turn that you can do. I'm gonna show it, but you are turning that combination, whatever leg is coming up, you're turning toward the way that the knee is pointing. So if my right leg is going up, I'm turning toward my right. If my left leg is going up, I'm turning toward my left. Don't stress yet. Don't stress yet. We haven't even done the turn. Okay. I'm going to show this with arms now. So you know the combination, but you do not know the arms. So don't stress about it. I am going to continue to face on this angle. You can face directly front, but I prefer turning from croisé, which is a crossed position facing your box's corner. So I'm going to start with my left leg front, facing my right corner. 7, arms second, 8. Tendu, cross, close, spin. Cross, close, spin. I'm going to show option A first. Cross, plie, 4th. Pull up to retire, promenade. Like wherever you can promenade, and then finish in the back. Really long, the same way that we did, but now you have arabesque arms, tendu, and then finish. Okay, so that's option A. One more time, I just want to show what a promenade is. You're just bouncing the heel up and down and trying to pivot your energy. And then wherever you get to, take the leg back, tendu, close. Yeah, if you make it a whole pivot around, great. If you make it two pivots around, great. The thing that I want you to really try to accomplish for yourself is finishing. So this is part two. When you think you're on it, so you're like, I'm just gonna go all the way around. And then it turns out you were like, not even on it. And then you fall all over the place and you feel like, ugh, frustrated, right? I want you to get to a place where you know, okay, I've done two really strong and now I'm just gonna take my leg back here. This is where I feel like I really successfully accomplished what I needed to accomplish, rather than like frustrating yourself just because, okay? I'm gonna show option B on the left. I mean, the right. What's happening? The right foot is in front. I'm facing my left box this corner. If I were to make a little box right here. Second position with the arms. Tendu one, close fifth two. Tendu three, close fifth four. Tendu five, I'm bringing my left arm in and I'm turning to my left. But I'm gonna rise now and try and land in that fourth. And then hold it for a second. We're gonna wait for like a full eight count and then finish. If you feel like you can do two, yes. But option B is that rise with a turn, okay? Remember what I said about the arm and the head? That is so important in this pirouette, where you wanna feel like the arm is opening out and your head is really quickly leaving just to find me again. I've heard oftentimes about leaving your head there and keeping it. While I do believe in that method, I think that that only, once again, applies to certain people. So I want you to try one pirouette, if you're doing the pirouette, where you are holding your focus here, turning, and then returning your focus back. Or directly in front of you, which would be a little higher for me. So leaving it and then finding it. Okay? Or a secondary way to think about it is actually moving your head first with your arm, so that it's the first thing to get back to your starting position. It's an alternate way of spotting. Give that a try. Here we go. Your head moves first. I see, I already have way more force there. It just naturally helps my body a little more, but whatever you feel. Okay, here we go. Option A, pivoting around, trying to stay really grounded on that standing leg. Option B, a full rise and a full turn. If you don't make it around for a full turn either, that's fine. If you're feeling like you can just do a quarter turn and then hit a land, it's the same as with the pivot people, where I would rather you finish and feel like, I just did that, than fall and be like, I didn't do it. You know what I mean? I get that way too. I'm not bullying you. I'm not bullying you. I do that. Oh, sorry. Okay. Here we go. It's just, you need a reminder every now and then. Being the best.
2.5, like a 3, like a 3. Okay, let's identify it. You do not have to type this. You don't have to type this, but this is what I do with all of my clients. So now that you've identified how it felt, what exactly do you think happened in your body that caused that response? It's hard to, it's really actually hard to identify something like that. Trying to figure out what did go wrong. Was it my weight? Like, did I throw my weight back? Did I open out my shoulder? Did I get too much force? Right. Yeah, sometimes you can get too much force and think you're good for a double. And then oftentimes I find when people really lose their balance in the second one, it's because they're scared. It's because they're like, oh my God, I'm going around a second time. And then they lose the focus on all of their alignment. In order to maintain multiple pirouettes, you can't think like, I'm really on my balance for this first one. Okay, I'm going for the second one. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Because the second you do that, it's like meditation where you have to return back your focus. And by that time, the turn is over. So it's really important when you're in your preparation to think like meditative state right now. Like I need to only focus on my body and my midline and nothing else. It's really hard to do. I'm not even saying that I have that mastered. Okay, all I wanna do is a little roll down, cool down. So just roll the spine down, legs comfortable distance apart. Shake your head out, plie. Stretch the legs. They don't have to straighten all the way. Plie, shake the head out. Stretch the legs. Walk the hands forward, bend the legs. Find a little baby downward dog. It doesn't have to be a full-blown one. And let's walk through the feet a little bit. Right foot, left foot. You can keep the legs bent. Five, six, seven, eight. Find length in the heels. They don't have to touch the ground. And then pull your core center in. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, melt the knees down to the ground. And just tuck the toes under and walk it back. Just rock from one foot to the other. We're just stretching out the big toe joint. If you feel like you can, take your hands up to the thighs, but even here, engage a little bit so you're not dumping into your foot. Engage a bit. Deep breath in. Exhale. Oh, I apologize if this is hurting any knees in closing. I am so sorry. I didn't think of an alternative before that moment. That's on me. Walk your hands in. Grab the elbows. Find length in the spine. Release the head. Close your eyes here. Find your inner smile. Release the hands to the ground. Plie. Slowest roll up of your life. Feel every vertebrae. Feel the skin of the back spread. Roll the shoulders open. Spine center. Close your eyes. Give yourself a big hug, squeeze a little harder, and say thank you, me. Thank you, me. And thank y'all for being here. Curtsy or bow. Thank you so much. I do these every other Saturday. They're usually 1 to 2 p.m. So this one was later because I did a live class with Yoga with Adrienne, who is my favorite. Okay. thank you so much. I'm like, my heart feels full, and I appreciate you all for being here. I accept Venmo donations or PayPal donations. Ava Gordy on Venmo. It's a business page, so in the search tab, it's like a different tab. Good luck. Or PayPal avagordy@yahoo.com. I appreciate everyone so much, and I will see you in 2 Saturdays. Bye, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your weekend.